Now I'd like to share with you the setup procedure for the Nerveäna system prior to a surgery. Every Nerveäna surgery kit comes with setup instructions, like this laminated set I have here. Furthermore, the Nerveäna itself has a diagram set up for the different types of surgeries that you'll be doing. So in any situation, you should have available the instructions you'll need to set up. Step one is to make sure the Nerveäna is charged the night before the surgery. The charge is good for 12 hours of surgery. Number two, once the Nerveäna is charged, bring it to the operating room and position it within 6 feet of the patient's head. Make sure to place the Nerveäna away from any electrocautery equipment. The electrocautery electrical noise can affect the performance of the Nerveäna system. Once you have the machine in place, now it's time to set up for the particular surgery that you're going to be doing. You're going to be doing one of three types of setup, either for thyroidectomy, parathyroidectomy, and ACDF, where the monitoring electrodes go on the endotracheal tube, and otologic surgery or parotidectomy, for example, you'll be monitoring the nerves of the face, the muscles of the face, and in neck dissection, you'll be able to monitor lower branches of the facial nerve and the muscles in the trapezius area for the accessory nerve monitoring. So determine which setup you're going to be doing and locate the appropriate surgery kit. Every surgery kit setup is going to involve placing monitoring electrodes on the patient and connecting to this EMG cable using color-coded ports. And then after that, setting up a stimulator cable with leads coming off the sterile field, with a lead coming off the sterile field that goes to a stimulator probe that's used by the surgeon. We always begin this second step in the process with the EMG side. That's what we want to be thinking about. What muscles are we monitoring right now? So, assuming, let's say you've placed your EMG electrodes, recording electrodes, on the face of the patient. Here for demonstration purposes, we'll use my forearm. Once that you've properly prepped the skin surface and placed your hydrogels, then you head over to your EMG cable, which you use this clip to clip it close to the patient's head, usually clipping it to the sheets or the pillow there near the head of the bed. And that's also shown in the illustrations on the top of the machine. So once you have this secured to the patient and the electrodes applied to the patient, you can then snap these into place, red, blue, and green in the middle, like so. At this point, make sure this EMG cable is connected to the back of the Nerveäna machine at the port labeled EMG, and turn the machine on. At this point, the sterile field hasn't really been set up around the patient, and the patient hasn't been prepped for sterility. And so you're able to test this connection, and if necessary, go back and reapply electrodes. So once I've turned on the machine and I have my signal amplification at 100%, I hold this test button for at least 6 seconds. And then I watch, when I release, the three readings that appear. In this case, I had 10, 16, and 7.8. Referencing my Nerveäna impedance guidelines on the top of the box, I can see that I needed to make sure all three of those numbers were under 20. Confirming that that's the case, I now know I've got good connection to the patient. With that done, you can proceed on now to setting up the stimulator side, step three. Plug this into the back of the machine and secure this cable near the patient's head, just as you did with the EMG cable, using this garment clip. Then locate the Stempack labeled stimulator pack that's found in each Nerveäna kit. Inside there's a red and a white wire. The white wire is a needle electrode that is the return for the stimulation applied by the probe. Direct the circulating nurse or the doctor to apply this needle subdermally in the shoulder, as shown in the illustrations. I'm going to just cover that up to avoid sticking myself. Okay. And once that's placed in the shoulder, cover it up with a piece of needle tape that's found in the surgery kit and snap that into the white color-coded port. This next inner packet that you'll find unlabeled has the red wire. One end of it is red, one end is blue. This is sterile. It needs to be dropped over on the sterile field, and the scrub nurse or scrub tech needs to pass out the red end off the sterile field to go into one of the red ports of the stim cable. This is typically done after the surgery has begun. And for that reason, it's important to keep this accessible, this cable assembly port accessible after the patient has been draped and potentially once the surgery's begun. For that reason, I will often clip it to the table here, but allow the head to hang down so it's easy to access from under the patient's drapes near the floor. With that said, it's time to discuss the stimulator probe and that final connection to have the Nerveäna ready for surgery. The Nerveäna utilizes reusable modified probes, forceps actually. They were modified to be a probe, and they have a metal post and they have a blue insulation, and then they have exposed tips that deliver stimulation, exposed metal. This needs to be sterilized prior to the surgery. So when I arrive on the morning of a surgery, I will pass this to the circulator nurse or the OR supervisor when I arrive so that they have time to flash sterilize it before the surgery begins. So with all that done, going back to the surgery setup, the scrub tech will take this wire that's on their scrub table, and I caution them to not just pull on it, but to make sure they unwrap it the first couple of times, and then after that, it comes apart quite nicely. So, see here, I get that undone, and then the whole thing comes, and it's quite long, and there's plenty of length to work with. What you need to remind the scrub tech is that the blue end of the wire goes to the blue instrument. This remains sterile. This is used by the surgeon with a forceful twisting motion that will fit snugly on the post of the instrument. This red tip is the end that's passed out off of the sterile field. This is typically hung out for either the circulator nurse or the Nerveäna factory rep to plug in to this stimulator port. And like I said, this should be hanging down lower away from the patient. You can come up under the drapes, and what you want to do is just get a nice snap sound, and you know that that has seated into the plug. Finally, verification of the connection is possible by touching the patient and testing that stimulation is being delivered. And I'm gonna show you what that sounds like. If the needle return is in the patient and you touch them somewhere, the current is gonna pass back to the needle. I'm gonna short circuit the patient by just showing you a direct path. So that clicking, ticking sound verifies that your probe is delivering stimulation to the patient. One more time. With that done, you are now able to confirm for the doctor that the system is set up properly and the surgery may proceed. Thank you.